Included with every brand new Ford F-150 Lightning and Mustang Mach-E is what Ford calls the mobile charger. It is nice that they give it to you because companies like Tesla actually no longer give you anything. But the question is, can you survive with just this to charge your F-150 Lightning or Mustang Mach-E? Or should you get a home charger installed? This is probably the most common question anyone has when they first get an EV because they want to know what additional costs go with getting an electric vehicle. Do I have to have a company come and install a whole charger at my house, or can I just use what Ford gives me? Now, the most simple answer is yes, you could actually just use this as your charger and never have to get any home charger installed. But this, in its standard form, in a regular home outlet, is going to charge your vehicle extremely slow. That doesn't mean that it can't be used for everyone. I've talked about this before when it comes to Teslas as well, but when you plug this into your standard home outlet, this will charge your vehicle and will give you a charge, but at a very slow rate of speed, which means depending on how many kilowatts you use of range, depending on how far you drive, you may or may not be able to get all that range back in a standard charging session. So let me kind of explain that to you. So as you can see, the Ford mobile charger charges at a rate of 1.1 kilowatt. Now, on an F-150 Lightning, for example, a typical range you'd expect per kilowatt is roughly 2 to 3 miles per kilowatt. Let me try to explain this as simple as possible for you. When you're driving an EV, you will basically get a rating, which is how many miles to a kilowatt that you get. This is kind of like your miles per gallon that you'd expect from like a gas vehicle. So on an F-150 Lightning, you may get, if you're driving very conservatively, 2.4 miles or 3 miles per kilowatt. Which means, let's say I take a 20-mile drive and I average 2 miles a kilowatt as my actual range. That would mean that in a 20-mile drive, as you do the math, it means I would use roughly 8 to 10 kilowatts of charge, which would get me about 20 miles. Now, this slow charger gets me 1.1 kilowatt per hour of actual charge, which means if I were to drive 20 miles, and I would be getting 2.5 miles to kilowatt, I would use roughly 8 to 10 kilowatts for those 20 miles. At a 1.1 kilowatt rate, it would take me 8 hours to get those 20 miles back in charge. 8 hours seems like obviously a long time, but let's just factor in the normal person that drives, let's say 30 to 40 miles in one day, and they get home from work at 5 p.m., and they don't go anywhere else the rest of the night, and they get home and they plug it in at 5 or 6 p.m., and the next morning at 6 or 7 a.m., they get in their vehicle, they've been charging for roughly 12 to 14 hours. So in those 12 to 14 hours, they've gotten roughly anywhere between 12 and 15 kilowatts added, which essentially does get them back that 30 to 40 miles. Now, this may sound confusing, but what I'm kind of saying is it's a very, very slow charge. It is not what you want to rely on. But if you are someone that actually only averages 20 to 40 miles in a day, you can actually get away with having this as your primary charger. Now, there are a couple major things to keep in mind. First is your kilowatt usage is really based on weather. If you live in a colder weather climate like I do, you may see range of about 1.5 miles to a kilowatt, or sometimes even lower depending on how much heat you're running and how you're driving. So you may now be using 20, 30, 40 kilowatts on a normal drive compared to your 10 or 15, which means it's going to be harder for it to get that energy back because of the slow speeds. Are you tracking a little bit how this math works? So you can see in just my app alone, I'm currently at 77% charge, and it says to charge from 77% to 80% would take till 7:16 p.m., which currently it's 4:45 p.m., to only get me 3% more battery. So we're talking about roughly 1% per hour of battery back on the charge. Very, very slow. But if I were to do my everyday driving of 20 to 30 miles, I'm only going to use about 10 to 15% battery on that. So I can get that back if I charge using this mobile charger. But if you were to compare that to, for example, a Tesla home charger, which I also have here, you can see that my charge rate is 8.7 kilowatts. So about eight times, a little over eight times the speed that it previously was. So now you can see that to get that 2% back, it's gonna take another 15 minutes total compared to the 3 hours. Now on the Ford Charge Station Pro, that actually is even faster than the Tesla charger, and you'll get about 20 kilowatts an hour of range, which obviously is ideally the way to go. When you own an EV, no question about it, level two charging, which is your standard home installation that an electrician would have to do for you, is definitely the way to go because you never really are worrying about range. You're able to charge from 20 to 80% pretty quickly in about 3 to 5 hours. And that's nothing because that's just basically plugging in when you get home and a couple hours later you're charged up. That's the way to go. If you are charging totally on just that mobile charger, you are going to be waiting a lot longer than you're going to be driving. You're going to be driving 10 miles to charge for 4 hours, which isn't ideal, but doesn't mean you can't make it happen. Now, one thing to keep in mind, Ford does include this NEMA 1450 adapter that basically just goes directly into this. So you could take this standard home outlet one off, plug this guy right into here, and connect this to your standard NEMA 1450. This is actually a way that a lot of people will get level two style charging much cheaper in their home, because instead of getting a Ford Charge Station Pro or a Tesla wall charger, electrician will basically just put a NEMA 1450 outlet in your house or your garage for very cheap. And you just plug that bad boy in and you'll get significantly faster charges than your standard, you know, home outlet. That's just another option to at least consider. It's a cheaper way to get level two charging, or at least much faster than the home charging, but it doesn't have necessarily the same smart features of being able to kind of control the charging station from your phone, which isn't a huge deal. You can do it from your truck or your car in general, your EV, but this is another common way that a lot of people do this. You will find some of these things actually at some Airbnbs and different places that are starting to put these out there for people that come with EVs. So that is a nice option. It's at least included, where the Tesla one at the time only came with this. So you can get that option as well if you don't go with a charge station or the home charger. So in summary, yes, you can use just the Ford mobile charger that comes with it. I would say this is much better used as a emergency backup. You go somewhere that you don't have any level two charger or supercharger or anything near you, and you just know that you're gonna be there for a bunch of hours and you can just plug it in and not really worry about it. It's better to at least be plugged in than nothing, because then at least you won't get any drain and you'll get some efficiency back. But overall, I would definitely recommend that you do some sort of level two home charger. I recommend the Ford one because it's the fastest, but Tesla home chargers work as well. That's the way to go. 1 kilowatt an hour is very slow, and you will use your battery very quickly and kind of find yourself always wondering if you're gonna make it to the next location. The way to go is level two charging. If you really wanna use this and not pay any money whatsoever for the Ford charge station and the install, you can just keep this. You just maybe wait a while. Hopefully this helps and wasn't too confusing. Feel free to ask any questions in the comments below. Happy to help. I love my EVs, and I think you will too.